Hey everyone, it's Nicole from Kenhub, and today we're going to be talking about the facial nerve. So the facial nerve is a highly complex and sometimes difficult nerve to grasp due to it having multiple functions and a fairly intricate path. And of course, in this tutorial, we're going to take a closer look at its anatomical course. But first off, we're going to start by looking at this image of a schematic of the facial nerve. And of course, we're looking at a human head from a lateral left view, with some of its internal organs visible, and the facial nerve here highlighted in green. And this, of course, is going to be our base image throughout the tutorial, and when we need to, we'll bring in another image to illustrate our point. But let's get cracking on the tutorial, and first I'm just going to give you a brief overview of what we're going to be talking about. So namely, we're going to be talking about the anatomy of the facial nerve, and of course we're going to break that down medially to peripherally into an intracranial portion, an intratemporal portion, and an extracranial portion. And just take a note that the extracranial portion can also be referred to as the branchial motor portion. We're also going to be talking about the brainstem nuclei associated with the facial nerve. And finally, we'll end with talking, as we always do, about some clinical correlations. But before we get cracking onto that, I just want to talk a little bit more about the facial nerve and some of its functions. So just sticking with our image of the facial nerve on the right here, you can see that the facial nerve belongs to a set of neural structures called the cranial nerves. These peripheral nerves are named due to their course through the cranium, which is the part of the skull that houses the brain and the brainstem. The facial nerve is also often referred to as cranial nerve 7, as it's the 7th cranial nerve out of 12, and it's often abbreviated as CNVII, as you can see on the left. It's also a bilateral nerve, that is, there's one on each side of the body, and the facial nerve serves many different functions associated with the head and neck, including general sensation to a small area of the ear, the special sensation of taste to the anterior two-thirds of the tongue, as well as some motor components from the parasympathetic innervation, which innervates the salivary glands, the mucus secreting glands of the nasal and oral cavities, and the lacrimal glands. And finally, the nerve provides branchial motor function to the muscles of facial expression and to the other small muscles associated with the ear. So now that we know all of that, let's move on to talk about the anatomy of the facial nerve. And the first section, of course, that we are going to talk about is the intracranial portion, which is also the most medial part, or the part that arises directly from the brainstem nuclei. So in this image, which we're zooming into a little bit, you can of course see the intracranial part highlighted in green. And you can also see the brainstem highlighted in blue, which is where the facial nerve arises, specifically the pontomedullary junction, which I've now highlighted for you in blue. And in this image, we can also see the internal acoustic meatus, encircled in blue, which is where the facial nerve enters the temporal bone. Let's just briefly take a minute to flip the brain and have a look at its inferior aspect so we can give you a bit of a deeper tour around these parts. And in this image, you can see the inferior view of the brain and the brainstem, showing the 12 paired cranial nerves projecting from the central nervous system, or otherwise known as the brain.
This video is not over yet. Continue watching now the full video at kenhub.com. We have lots more videos like this one available to our premium members on our website, not to mention all the fun quizzes, related articles, and atlas sections. So click on the button in the middle to watch the full-length video and master anatomy.